Hi there, I'm Nick Karpowitz. I work as a scientist, specifically in attosecond physics. So why do I think that we should all switch to Linux in 2026? This video is mostly for other scientists, although people working in other technical fields will likely feel some similarities to the impressions that I have. For me, I need my computer to do work. I do simulations, I process data, I write papers, I attend conferences, and I need to be able to rely on my computer to help me with all of these things. So why do I use Linux for this? I have one negative reason and one positive. Let's get the negative thing out of the way first. This is that Microsoft is bad and has been getting worse. Windows is full of ads and dark patterns. It's never no, it's maybe later. And I think it all comes down to a deliberate misunderstanding of consent in their push to get everyone to use their AI. And Copilot has made this much, much worse on top of the privacy and security concerns. What made me kind of snap about this was last year when the price of Office 365 went up. The way that they went about this was they included Copilot and increased the price at the same time, and they opted you into this new plan with a higher price. But it turned out that if you went to cancel, you could have the old plan without Copilot at the same price that you were paying before. So essentially, they were just trying to force everybody to upgrade into having access to Copilot, which I didn't want. And I feel basically they tried to scam me. I don't want my computer to be run by scammers. The next issue is memory prices and the push to the cloud. If you use Office, I'm sure you've noticed that you can only auto-save documents that are saved onto OneDrive, and this is to force you to depend on their cloud services. I remember when I canceled my Office subscription, this was the biggest pain, was getting all of my data out of this, because it's very unclear what is saved locally on your computer and what is on OneDrive. So securing all of your data once they have it is actually a big pain. This is on purpose, to lock you into a subscription. All of this cloud computing stuff comes at a time when memory prices have been going crazy due to the construction of data centers for AI and cloud services. While this is happening, Microsoft is ending support for Windows 10. There are millions of perfectly good computers that can't upgrade to Windows 11 because of fairly arbitrary restrictions that Microsoft has put in place, which are for their benefit and not for the benefit of the user. Linux is a way to keep safely using these systems, which both prevents e-waste and also keeps you from having to buy new hardware in the middle of an affordability crisis. This is all part of a pattern of behavior which is common to American tech giants. I'd recommend watching Cory Doctorow's recent CCC conference presentation, which I'll link in the description. All right, so that's the negative part over. Next, I want to talk about why Linux makes me hopeful for the future of computing. The main thing is that it's good now. I remember when Linux was janky. I installed it before because I wrote this open source software that I wanted to work on all the big three platforms, so I had to test it on Linux, so I needed to install it on my PC. So what changed? One thing that changed was the release of KDE Plasma 6. This is the newer version of the desktop environment that I'm using now, and it just fixed a lot of the problems to such an extent that on this computer that I was dual booting in Linux and Windows to do my development work, I found that I actually preferred to leave it in Linux just naturally. The next thing is reliability. My desktop and laptop aren't doing anything behind my back, and I can trust them to keep doing tomorrow the same things that they were doing today. The version of Linux that I'm going to recommend in a bit has an especially powerful mechanism for ensuring this kind of reliability. So regarding switching, I think a big reason that people had trouble in the past switching from Windows to Linux is that they would try to start with the operating system. But really, the operating system isn't the most important part of your computer. A lot of the times it's the applications that you're using on top of it. So what people would do is they would replace Windows with Linux, but people who use Windows for their work are used to Windows software. If you have to replace everything all at once, all of the software that you're using, it can be overwhelming. So what I recommend is to start looking at the open source alternatives that are available to the software that you use and try those first on your current system before you change anything. An important one is Office software. There are a few different Office suites available. I've been using one called Only Office for the past few months. It has really good compatibility with Microsoft products, so files from PowerPoint open fine. I didn't have any formatting issues if I had to transfer my documents to a presentation PC at a conference. And there's another one that I really like called Collabora Office, which I'll link both of these in the description below. They're both free. I recommend just having both of them installed. If you get a file that doesn't work with one, it'll probably work in the other one. And they both have interfaces that are going to be familiar if you've used Office before. The next thing which is important is a LaTeX editor. There are millions of these. I like one called Kile. It works fine. It does everything that I need. Next thing is code editors. The most popular one is probably Visual Studio Code, which is available for Linux. My favorite one is called Zed, which is super fast and beautiful. The next thing is going to be Python. This is, of course, available. It's probably easier to get it installed than on Windows. I recommend using UV for managing virtual environments, but otherwise it's going to be the same stuff. And then finally, in science, you'll often need specialized applications. Unfortunately, I can't comment on those. Everybody has their own. I will say that there's a program called Bottles that makes it easy to run Windows programs under Linux. So if you have something that you need to run, give it a shot under Bottles. Now let's talk about which flavor of Linux to use, the distribution. I think there's often too much of a focus on choosing a distribution when recommending that people try Linux, because how can you make a good decision when you're just starting out? So I'm just going to recommend one. It's called Bazite. When you install it, the only decision that you have to really make is if you have an NVIDIA GPU, you get the NVIDIA version. Bazite is what's called an immutable distribution. This means that the core of the system is read-only and it gets updated at once as a pre-configured image. And this image is well separated from the layer on which you put your applications. This separation solves the problem where your operating system gets slowly messed up over time. If you've ever had a problem where you had to just freshly install Windows to fix a computer, this prevents that kind of situation from happening. One thing that you'll notice is that Bazite's main audience is gamers, not scientists, but there is a surprising amount of overlap between our needs. We just want to get our hardware working efficiently and the operating system out of the way so that we can do our stuff. I'm recommending Bazite because it has a fairly large community behind it. The only really gamery thing is that by default it launches Steam on startup, but you can take it as your first exercise in Linux customization to disable that in the auto start settings. There's also a more plain version of the same concept by the same Universal Blue group, which produces Bazite, which is called Aurora, which is a very similar system to Bazite without the gamer branding, but it also has an order of magnitude fewer users. And I think there can be strength in numbers, which is why I'm recommending just to install Bazite. And if you have to search for solutions to things in any case, the good search term to use is Bazite. In the end, the operating system is just a substrate. The immutable approach means you can play around with things, you can learn how to use the system with much less worry that you'll mess something up in the process. You can install and uninstall whatever you want. It's fine. Just go try things, experience things. Now for installing Bazite itself, I'm not going to go into details here. There are lots of other videos on YouTube. So that basically covers what I wanted to talk about today. I think the Linux ecosystem is in a good spot. It's a good time to try it out, to cost effectively keep using the hardware that you have for longer. For the work that I do as a physicist, I found that it actually works better than the commercial options. And it's the only operating system among the big three that respects and works with me rather than for its shareholders. Thanks for hearing me out on this. Let me know if this kind of tangentially scientific thing is a useful addition to this channel. You can click the buttons below, leave a comment, that sort of thing. In any case, have a good day.